From state to state, America has come to grips that men and women in state and federal prisons are testing positive for COVID-19. Although coronavirus cannot just travel through brick walls, we can in fact presume the deadly virus was walked into prisons by its employees over and over again. So what about inmates serving their time? They have widely been the very last to be considered for testing. Is that because prison employees have had to lose their own lives for state attorney generals to realize that inmates were probably exposed to this pandemic? Possibly. If hundreds of male and female inmates are testing positive now, that is because they were never tested before now. Why is this unknown? Because there are assets and liabilities when it comes to prison systems. There is no law that is written that men and women must be treated like dirt. Nevertheless, the U.S. commercialized prison system now has global attention because the number of positive COVID-19 cases have increased due to massive crowding. If trillions of dollars of free money can be printed by the U.S. Mint and given to taxpayers by way of economic impact checks, then there are plenty of inmate cases that can be reviewed for immediate and favorable adjudication. As we all know, however, some inmates serving sentences that obviously would render unfavorable adjudications due to more harsh crimes. Economic impact checks served a purpose to help stabilize the economy, support families and individuals. If the federal government can sort an entire nation, categorize them, and serve them into groups of essential, unemployed, small business owner, college student, taxpayer, single, married, or dependent, then why hasn't the government radically empowered itself to safeguard the lives of inmates? We're not sure, but we can ask this question. If the federal government does not work with the federal, state, and local law enforcement municipalities to begin a civil humanitarian reduction of overcrowded prisons, the prison system will find itself stuck with higher turnover rates of qualified men and women who deem risking their lives daily entering affected spaces where they must work. They are essential employees. Let's back up here just a bit. The first priority of coronavirus in late February, early March, was due to massive crowds gathering. So states all across America canceled or postponed events due to major concerns to help prevent the spread of coronavirus. Now, we can talk about inmates in American prisons. So when exactly did prisons begin doing massive testing for inmates? It was reported on April 23rd, 2020 by The Hill that the majority of inmates at Westville Correctional Facility in Westville, Indiana, tested positive for COVID-19. We're talking 92%. During this time, Attorney General Barr ordered facilities in a number of states, including Louisiana and Ohio, where one prison reported nearly 2,000 confirmed cases of the virus, to release some offenders amid the outbreak. A story by the Associated Press on April 9, 2020 showed inmates at Monroe County Complex in Washington State Department of Corrections from a helicopter where all men were seated outside in a demonstration after six inmates tested positive. These men know their legal rights and civil rights. Not only did the entire nation watch this peaceful demonstration, but what we all saw was these men collectively choosing life. The next day, on April 10, 2020, Melissa Segarra, BuzzFeed, reported that in upstate New York at Wynn Correctional Facility, inmate David Sell was quarantined 7 days for COVID-19. He says he did not receive any medical care or even a change of clothes. He said he had to plead with prison staff to clean the thermometer before taking his temperature. He said, "I asked the doctor, how am I going to be treated?" he said, and she was basically just like, "Ride it out." So America can look at inmates becoming infected and passing away from coronavirus with the law of double jeopardy, meaning if inmates were already adjudicated for crimes and misdemeanors and given time only, then the attorney generals for all states should be taking a proactive approach so that inmates are not being given a second sentence by not taking aggressive action to rectify the spread of coronavirus within their state prisons. Otherwise, their practices may be seen as double jeopardy. WHAS 11 ABC talked to leaders within the justice system who are taking a hard look at how prisons are being impacted by COVID-19. Some criminal justice reformers say now is the time to release inmates from jails and prisons since it's impossible to social distance in those close quarters. Back on March 1st, 2020, the Louisville Metro Department of Corrections had over 1,800 inmates. As of April 23rd, 2020, that number was reduced to 1,280. That included testing of 95 people, resulting in no positive tests. Texas is a massive state geographically. On April 27, 2020, it was reported that 900 inmates and 325 staff tested positive for COVID-19 throughout the Texas Department of Criminal Justice Prison. Texas reported nearly 18,000 inmates currently on medical restriction, where an inmate who is well but has been exposed to a communicable disease has been separated from the population and/or movement has been restricted to prevent the spread of the disease. I'm Shawn Journalist Jackson at Black World Journal.